The Leather Archives and Museum currently has approximately 150 vests, 170 title holder sashes, countless uniforms, jackets, belts, and other clothing within its leather textile collection. Many of these items are stored in the Leathers Room inside LANM's climate-controlled archive. While it is a sight to behold so many historic, well-worn, and well-loved objects in one location, the growing Leathers collection was starting to outgrow the existing 9-foot by 11-foot Leather Room. In the spring of 2013, LANM Board of Directors were presented a plan to move the tool room that was originally built by the previous building owners up to the building's loading dock and prop shop. This move freed up a 10-foot by 20-foot space that is conveniently located off the main archives room. The HVAC system was reconfigured to provide additional cooling to that room to make a more acceptable environment for leathers and clothing. Lighting controls for the auditorium as well as computer and phone equipment were moved or reconfigured as well. And so was born the new Leathers Room.
This has been a whole lot more of an open space for me. I can spread out. All of the leathers are here, and rather than having to locate whatever I'm working on, taking it down, shimmying out of the aisle, and then going way across through the hallway, bumping into all kinds of other storage containers and whatnot, and then spreading out on a table that's in a completely different open space. I have my table right here. So it just goes from there to there and back again, or into a quarantine, but it's all in here.
Once LANM Director of Operations Jeff Storer began to build out the new Leathers Room, he remembered how many visitors to the LANM were impressed by the sight, smell, and energy of the old Leathers Room as all those vests and sashes hung in full view for everyone to enjoy. Because he wanted visitors to continue to enjoy the Leathers Room, he brought to the board a revised design plan that made the new Leathers Room an exhibit of sorts. The team at LANM understand how important these items are to their owners and to friends and family of those who have passed. And as a result, Jeff built the room so it serves as a showplace for our leathers and a place where people can be in awe of the collection and all that goes into preserving it. Anyone who comes to the LANM and wants to see the collection will be escorted into the archives and to the Leathers Room so they can see the amazing history people have donated.
We were very much in need of expansion simply because the volume of things. I mean, if you look in here, you're seeing pretty much what was contained in the other room, but there was no room on the hangers in the other room to expand anymore. We also needed a space where we could isolate certain items that have, you know, possibly borderline issues like mold, some of the green crud that is infectious to other items, so you don't want them physically in contact with one another until they're cared for, and then they can go back into the mingling. Now we have the opportunity, given this space, to be able to do those things.